they put it in the hands of the quarterback Monroe. Michigan was ready for him and stoned him short of the goal line. And J.J. McCarthy, as you said, Kirk, moments any quarterback would dream about. He drove his team down the field at the end of regulation. It was the winning game that got it done at OT.
How did you get this win?
It was team effort. We never do an adversity here. We had some adversity today. Couldn't stop it, but we came together as one. You know, I'm my brother's keeper. I know my brother's had my back. And I told him, if we score, we try to stay up good overtime, we're going to win. But we came out of time. I'll see you in Houston.
You have the ball. It's 4th and 2. You guys have to go for it to save your season. What was the huddle like on that play that Ron Wilson came up with a big play?
You know, Ron previously had a mistake. He said, I promise, I'm going to make a play. That's what Roman did. We all had faith in him. We all believed him. You know, he was just playing hard. You know, things happen. I love my guys. I love my guys. I don't really know what to say right now. I'm just blessed. I want to thank God for just allowing me to be here. This time last year, I wasn't here. You know, so I just want to thank God, you know, full circle, full 365, and I'm blessed.
All right. We will see you in Houston. Thank you so much. Let's head over to Laura with J.J. McCarthy.
Thank you, Holly. J.J., you wanted to get your rose really badly. You just ran across the field to go get it. Why was it so important to you?
You know, this game just means so much to me, and I had superstition like back in hockey. I had to do it the Stanley Cup, and I didn't touch it all week, and I just was waiting for this moment to, you know, put it in my mouth. Yeah.
You vowed that this team would get back to the college football playoff. Now you've got an opportunity to play for a national championship. What can you say about the fight of this group?
I mean, the fight started week one. I mean, everything we've been through, all the adversity, you know, it's a team that goes through that adversity and can't get to the heights that we're trying to reach. So I feel like we just did a tremendous job of responding through all that and pushing through. And we've got one more game left, so it's job's not finished yet.
You just bent over and you're kind of looking around and overcome a little bit. How would you describe the emotions that you're feeling right now?
It's indescribable just because the last 2 years, being able to watch the opposing team celebrate, it's just different when I see the Mason Blue confetti on the field. And, you know, just nothing. I'm nothing without this head coach, nothing without my teammates, nothing without that defense. I mean, everything was so amazing. It's just really, really amazing.
Congratulations, Junior.
Thank you so much, Laura.
Chris.
I love this Stanley Cup reference. He was a hockey first athlete who was freshman year high school. He could have played on any sport. But a moment. Very, very close relationship between, of course, the 15-year NFL quarterback. That's what they call it. Much more to talk about this before we kick into New Orleans. The second semifinal coming up in 10 minutes. The Ram Truck postgame show is coming up right now. Michigan down 7 late. Scores the
defense has to step up. And what's interesting is they motion here. Junior Colson will eventually go out, but add up the Michigan defenders. You've got 6 blockers, and you've got 7 inside. Derek Moore does a good job right here of winning his battle. Gets inside of Dupree. That really blows the play up, but look at the maze of blue. They're not getting pushed off the ball. Game on the line, season on the line, and a one final time, a battle in the trenches, and it's Michigan that wins. 8 on the edge, Moore, Kenneth Brandt on the inside. It's the Michigan defensive line, which has been a strength of theirs all year long, makes the play here to secure this win in overtime.
One more time, a low snap that Elroy had to deal with on that final play.
Might have affected his momentum going forward, but I don't think he's getting into the end zone.
So Saban denied a chance. It's going to be